Hey guys, it's Lefty back again, and I want to talk to you today about DUI. I made a video. I've talked about this topic a lot. Whenever it comes up, I don't shy away from talking about it and giving my thoughts. And I made a video a while back about an experience I had where I was listening to the radio and I heard a PSA about DUI laws and cautioning people about the dangers of drunk driving and of course the fallout from getting caught. And I said some things that that people had issue with, and the other night on PKA, the topic of impaired driving came up again, and then that spun into a talk about DUI, and some people again disagree, and we're actually conflating my argument with other asinine things that I didn't actually say. Some of it was happening on the PKA subreddit, so I wanted to make a clarification because I think that. I don't want to pat myself on the back. I think my point may be too nuanced for its own good, or I think I may not just devote enough time to explaining my point fully. Maybe I'm just not good at effectively communicating. I don't know. It's entirely possible. But I want to point out, I make a habit of sarcastically whenever we talk about DUI laws and deterrence. Now, I want to state for the start of the video, okay? In this instance, when I say DUI, I don't mean DUI that's tacked on to a fatal accident or an injurious accident. I don't mean a traffic accident. I mean some guy that gets stopped by a cop who's just driving along, hasn't hurt anybody, and won't hurt anybody because he ends up getting arrested. But I'm talking about that. I'm talking about non-injurious cases where there isn't an accident, there isn't a fatality, nobody's harmed in any way. It's just a guy who's drunk on the road. Injurious DUI is different. If you're just reckless and you hurt somebody, well, that's a problem. But I'm talking specifically here about instances where people are just drunk on the roads and haven't hurt anybody. And I think that our society, at least in America, the incredible punishments levied against people that are just caught drunk on the roads are completely unreasonable. I think it is unreasonable to perhaps even irrevocably alter people's lives for being caught DUI. Not hurting anybody, but just being DUI. I think that's unreasonable for an impaired driving instance to alter your life significantly for years to come. Years. Money, monetarily, and just from the fact that in our society you have to have a car if you want to do anything, you have to have a means of transportation. Public transportation is a joke. Don't come at me with that. But I think it's unreasonable to do that to people who haven't hurt anybody. But I want to make a clarification because when talking about it, a lot of people make the when it's posed, it's like, well, perhaps the punishments are unreasonable. The most common that I've found response is, well, they are very harsh punishments because they're supposed to act as a deterrent. You're not supposed to want to be caught DUI because these bad things will happen to you. Well, then I make the point, well, why don't we just summarily execute people? That would be an effective deterrent, right? That if you just execute somebody on the side of the road for being DUI, you better damn well hope that people are like, oh crap, I don't want to get shot. Of course I'm not going to be DUI. Now, some people have seized on this and act like that's my argument. Like, oh, Lefty's a moron because, of course, it's stupid to execute people. That's the point. That's why I say it. Because the reason I bring that up is because it's unreasonable. Very few people, if any at all, you're all smart. Of course it's unreasonable to execute people for being DUI. That's unreasonable. The reason I bring that up is to get people to say that it's unreasonable. Because once you say that, well, no, summarily executing DUI offenders on the side of the road who haven't hurt anybody is completely unreasonable. That completely overrides the need for deterrence in the law and the punishments. At that point, they have conceded that it isn't just about deterrence. At that point, when somebody says, I think these punishments are unreasonable for these reasons, the response of, well, it's just a deterrent, or it's supposed to be a deterrent, no longer holds any water. Because those people will turn around and concede, well, of course deterrence is overridden by being reasonable to people who haven't hurt anybody. That's the point. It's to define the playing grounds. Because once you say, well, let's go to the extreme, is that unreasonable? Well, yeah, of course. Then it's not just about deterrence. At some point, some nebulous point, deterrence is subjugated by the need to be reasonable to people. You can't just execute people on the side of the road. You can't put them in jail for life for being DUI. That's unreasonable. And that's the whole point. Because then we have to have a discussion on the merits of what is reasonable to do to people. Then it is about, well, let's discuss what is reasonable. Of course, my point has never been that, well, we should just execute people on the side of the road then. Ha ha ha, look, your points are stupid because deterrence and da 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 da. No, the point is, everybody will agree that executing people or extreme punishments are unreasonable. But the idea is that it is to get people to properly define terms, and when you get somebody to admit, and when you admit, well, deterrence isn't the ultimate issue. Because at some point when deterrence is trumped by being reasonable, deterrence isn't the ultimate end goal. It's just not. And then we have to have a discussion on what's reasonable. And that's where I want the discussion to be. I don't want the discussion to be about deterrence. Because, again, many people will admit that deterrence at some point becomes just not tenable anymore. And then now we get into, well, why do I believe that DUI punishments are unreasonable? Well, that could be a whole, we have to get into impaired driving, and that's a whole other subject. But I will suffice it to say that I think the core issue of DUI, the core issue of wanting to not have people drunk on the road, is because you want to limit impaired driving. When you're an impaired driver, you're more dangerous. That's just a fact. It doesn't matter how you're impaired. When you are impaired to a certain degree, and perhaps in certain ways, there's probably nuance to that, and I think I'm not up on the studies. I'm sure it's studied over and over again, and if not, it should be. But if you are impaired, you're a danger. That's just it. It doesn't matter if you're high, if you're drunk, if you're texting, if you're talking, if you're asleep because you're on Valium or whatever. If you're impaired, you're a danger. And DUI, through very effective lobbying and endless appeals to emotion about, think of the dead children. These people were killed by a DUI driver. We have arrived at a point in society where one single subset of impaired driving is so out of whack compared in terms of punishment to other forms of impaired driving. Many municipalities and states have even passed no texting while driving, no talking on the cell phone while driving laws, but those pale in terms of punishment, those pale in comparison to what happens to you if you get caught DUI in America. Your life is so significantly impacted. And no, PK subreddit, I don't really have any connections to anybody that has had a DUI. I've never been DUI. It's just, I am allergic to bullshit, and this I see as bullshit, so I'm passionate about it. It's fun to talk about, too, except when people are just, you know, when they feel insecure about their own intellectual prowess, and so they, you know, just use ad hominem attacks on you, and like, oh, yeah, lefty's such a fucking moron, because, of course, blah, blah, blah. But I think it's unreasonable, because a single subset of impaired driving has been singled out and made completely the punishments just so severe compared to the rest of everything else, to the rest of impaired driving, that's unreasonable. That is completely unreasonable. We're not Puritans. Drinking alcohol is not illegal. And just to single out drunk driving because of drunk doesn't make any sense. It's actually about impaired driving. So if you're going to want to punish impaired drivers, punish all of them. Punish all kinds of impaired drivers, or punish people commensurate with their level of impairedness. But I look around and I see texting while driving is a fine, but it's not jail time. It's not, you have to pay $5,000 or more for a lawyer, or you're going to be without your license for 5 years. I don't see that. And so I think it's completely unreasonable to so significantly and possibly irrevocably unhinge people's lives because of effective lobbying and a punishment system that has failed to keep up and has just been ransacked by appeals to emotion and the lobbying. So no, I don't actually mean that we should. My point isn't, oh, if you, it should be, we should execute people. See, that's unreasonable. Ha ha, my point is made. DUI is okay. No, that's not my point. My point is that most people would probably admit that at some point unreasonable punishment trumps deterrence. Okay, then we don't talk about deterrence anymore. Let's just talk about what's reasonable. That's why I bring up that reductio ad absurdum to point out, oh, well, yeah, of course there's a point where deterrence isn't the trump card, isn't the ace in the hole. Well, then let's have a talk about what is reasonable. And so if you know, talk about this all you want. You know, if you feel the need, I like talking about it, but if you feel the need to just, you know, use ad hominem attacks and just reply to conflated points of argumentation that I didn't even say, and try to degrade me because you're insecure about your intellectual stature, and this makes you feel good, and this makes you feel all right in the head, it's okay. You and I both know it's just to cover up the insecurities that you have. It'll be our little secret. Anyway, guys, that's my time. I got to get out of here. Thank you for joining. I hope you enjoyed. Be sure to drop a like on this video if you did enjoy. The march to 100K continues. I can't wait. It's going to be awesome. Thank you to everybody that's helped make this trip possible so far, and to everybody that will help get us there in the hopefully the coming months. Thank you guys for joining. I hope you enjoyed. I'm out. Peace.